In this lecture, we are going to look over the basic concepts of Lightning Web Component. Whenever you're going to create LWC, you will require three files: HTML file, JavaScript file, and configuration file. So now let's look into our example where we're going to create very first Lightning Web Component, which is going to display the current date and time. To do that, let's jump into the Visual Studio. If I go over here, Visual Studio, and if I right click on LWC, say create Lightning Web Component, I'll give a name, current date time. Now SFDX has created three files for me. First file is HTML file, second is JS, and third is the meta file. Now let's talk about the HTML file. Anything that you write in the HTML has to be included into the template tag. Template is the root tag which is being used in Lightning Web Component. So anything on your user interface has to be included into template tag. If I look into the JS, it has imported the Lightning element from the LWC library. Also, we have an export default class because whatever we are going to write over here, we want it to be exported out of this Lightning Web Component. That's why we have an export over here. Now, if we go back to our presentation, the HTML file again is the UI component with a root tag of template. JavaScript file has got LWC, which imports Lightning element from the LWC module. Then Lightning element is a custom wrapper. So if I go back, this Lightning element is a custom wrapper around the HTML. And export helps us to make sure that whatever component we have, that can be used by other component also. The last one is configuration file, where whatever component you make, you want to specify the target, and you can also specify whether it is to be exposed or not. If I make it true, then it is ready to be exposed, but I also have to specify the target where it needs to be exposed. This particular Lightning component is available on app page, record page, and home page. Now let's go ahead and write our very first Lightning component. We are going to write a Lightning component which has an H1 tag which says my first LWC and date is 7th April, which I have put it in a paragraph. So let's save this now. I have saved this, Control S, and over here also Control S. Now I'm going to push this to the org. So I'll say deploy source. I just right click deploy source to org. Let it get deployed. Now let's jump into Salesforce. Over here, let's edit the page to add the newly created Lightning Web Component. So this is my component, current date and time. I'll add it, I'll hit save. Let's go back. So this is my first LWC, date is 7th April. Over here, if I go back, we have hard coded the date. Now can we make it dynamic, which will come from our JavaScript file? To do that, we'll first define a property. Let that property name be tdate, and we are specifying it in a curly braces. Now this needs to be referenced in my JS file. To do that, we have something called as decorators. Let me now go back to presentation. Now there are three types of decorators that we use: API, which indicates is a public property or method. track which private property if I want to track it, wire if I want to get the data from Salesforce. In our example, we are going to use API. The reason being, we want to re-render the component as soon as the property changes. So let's go back and we'll say comma API, and over here, so we are tracking a particular property. The property name is tdate. Let's copy this. We'll say at the rate API tdate semicolon. Then we are going to make use of a JavaScript function which is going to return me the current date and time and put it in a variable tdate. And this will then be reflected over here in my HTML. So let's save this. Let's save this. Let's save this. And now we are going to again deploy source to org. Let's go back and refresh this particular Lightning Web component. Now it has come, date is Sunday, April 7, 2019. So we have just created a Lightning Web component using the very basic principles, that is, it consists of three files, HTML, JavaScript, configuration. To do binding, we make use of decorators like API, track, and wire. In our example, we did a very basic binding where we have a property by name tdate. This tdate gets the latest date and time from our JavaScript and returns it on the HTML. Thank you.